Hi guys, welcome back to the vlog. My name is Freya and here we discuss trans identity issues. In this episode we discuss cis terms for genetic women. Now I am post-op trans female and this gives me some kind of understanding about what we're talking about, we're going through. I've just remembered I've forgotten something, the mic cover for the microphone, so hopefully this audio isn't too bad. So a lot of genetic women have commented on the channel saying that they find it offensive that we use the term cis, and I didn't grow up with that phrase. Doctors and the medical team industries, they were using those phrases, and they do come from scientific based areas of when you're talking about molecules and things to do with science. I'm not a science student, I'm a history student, so I can't even talk to you about that with any kind of academia, but no offence is meant by it. I think the thing is when a collective group start to use a term too much, it just gets into circulation. I always prefer the term genetic, and I don't even know when cis started and when this term started, but I think if a lot of you speak about what it is that you find offensive, if you say that to a trans person, they won't say it. You know, as soon as someone said to me they felt that way, then I said sorry, and I would just say genetic women. I think it's very hard to say only women because it's a very broad spectrum now. So I know that you're probably hanging on to the fact that 50 years ago it wasn't a spectrum based thing, but now it is. Gender is a spectrum based thing. You're going to meet people in your life that either identify as male, female, and it's kind of, yes, I know a lot of you are going to say, oh, there's only two genders and stuff like that, but okay, but in the modern world is that life is becoming more diverse, so I'm going to say either genetic women or trans women now. And even that, you can't even, how are you going to make the LGBT women happy with that, because they see themselves as, you know, trans women see themselves as 100% women, so again they're going to be offended as well. And no offense meant, I am trans myself. I would say that if we just class each other all under the same, you know, umbrella as women, it's a huge diverse group now, and I think that's the only way to move forward. I think if we're picking at each other all the time over the terms, then we're not really going to help each other. I personally am not actually bothered about how you identify me. I think a lot of people online have tried to snipe at me by saying, oh, you know, you're not a proper woman, or you're a man and stuff like that, but you're not going to bother me because I don't care about my pronouns. You know, I think when you get to the end of this stage, you become so much more laid back. You're not easily offended, so keep going because I don't care. And what else? Yeah, I'll just say be respectful to everyone else. And I would apologize to any women who find the term cis upsetting. We don't mean it as a group, and let's try and move on from it. Okay, so thanks guys, please leave comments below and see you soon. Bye.